This is just a regular get ready with me video. So starting barefaced, I use this Smart Mud Mud Mask. It's basically a mud mask, but without all the mess. So you peel off one layer and then stick it to your skin and then peel off the second layer. Turns out I'm really, really bad at it, so it took me a while to get it to stick to my face, but I actually really love this mask and I had a lot of fun doing this. So all you have to do is stick it to your face, leave it on for about 10 minutes or longer if you so desire, and it pulls out all these impurities from your pores. Then once it's dry, you peel it off. And honestly, I've had mud baths before and I went into it not expecting much, but it makes your skin feel great. So then I rinsed it off and used this orange blossom toner from Fox Brim and just used a little cotton pad to get that all over my face. Then I used my Truth Serum from Ole Henriksen, put that everywhere as well, and then I sealed in all of that goodness with my X-Hydro Gel Moisturizer. I love this stuff because it absorbs super well, so if I'm going to be putting some sunscreen over it, I know it's not going to feel too heavy on my skin with this underneath. Then after that, I did my old go-to Bienfait UV 50 Plus from Lancôme, and I put that all over my face and neck as well. Then I used my Cover FX foundation. This is a mineral foundation, it's a pressed powder, and I just love this foundation, it settles into my skin really well. Then I used my regular old Idun Minerals concealer under my eyes, on any blemishes that I had or redness, and then around my nose. Then I sealed that in with some Makeup Forever HD powder that I'm trying desperately to use up. Then I used my old standby Coralista and then this Graftobian Cosmetics bronzer. And I just put this on a regular fluffy brush. I did that underneath my cheekbones and then around my hairline and under my chin for some nice dimension to my face. Then I used this Cover FX highlighter. It's a liquid highlighter. I put some on the back of my hand and then dipped into it. And I put it on my cheekbones and my brow bones. Then I used my NYX California palette. I did this light cream color all over my eyelids. I love using my finger to apply this because it heats it up nicely. Then I went in with this orange on a fluffy brush and I worked that into the crease. Now the thing I don't like about this palette very much is it's not super pigmented, so I really have to build up all of the colors from this palette, and I have to tap it off of my brush quite a bit too, otherwise I get a ton of fallout from it. So it's not my favorite palette, but it has some great colors. Then I used this gold all across my eyelids and I just carried this up into the crease of my eyelids and again patted this on and built it up the same way I did with the orange before, just to get a little bit of autumn colors going. Then I used this light mocha color and worked that into the crease as well over not quite as broad of an area as I did with the orange. Then after that, I went into this darker brown color, the darkest one on the palette, and I patted that into the outer corners of my eyes, and then a tiny bit underneath along that lash line as well. Then I went back in with my finger and used that orange color and just added a tiny little splash of color just underneath where I put on that dark brown underneath my lower lash line. Then I used this Graftobian Cosmetics eyeliner and liquid, and this liquid is really fantastic. I usually just use water for my eyeliner, but this liquid holds the eyeshadow in place. So you just add it to your powder and then go in with your flat brush, and it replaces the moisture that you need to actually get the powder to a nice liquid state so you can smooth it on, but then it sets it into place like no other. It's absolutely fantastic. I love the way this turned out. And I don't usually use black eyeliner, but for this look, I wanted to make sure that it popped because I was using quite a bit of brown eyeshadow and I wanted to differentiate between my lash line and the rest of the eyeshadow look. So I did that along my lower lash line. Then I used a different flat brush into this nice taupe color. This is a little bit warmer than what I usually use, but since I was using a lot of bronzer and the whole effect was warmer than usual, I figured I'd go for it in this instance. And I just used that in my brows the same way I always do, doing the tail a little bit heavier and then filling in the rest of them. I don't go very heavy on my brows, just enough so that you can actually tell that they exist. Then I went in with this gold glitter, and this is specifically designed to be worn around your eyes. Don't use craft glitter, it could get on your cornea and scratch it, make you go blind. I patted that onto the inner corners of my eyes and the outer corners, then I curled my eyelashes like I always do and used my favorite go-to All May mascara. same one I always do. I did that on the top lashes, working it side to side, and then a little bit on the outer lower lashes as well. Then I used this Clarins Instant Light Lip Comfort Oil. This one has a little bit of color, unlike the green one that I usually use, and I love the way this makes my lips feel. It's so nice and smooth and moisturizing. Then I used my Graftobian Cosmetics bronzer again, and this time I used the brush that comes with it and just did a little bit of bronzer on the sides of my nose and then underneath my nose just to give it a little bit of shape. And then I took that same Cover FX highlighter, put a little in the center of my lower lip, then across the bridge of my nose and a little bit on the tip of my nose as well. Then I started brushing out my hair and just getting the knots out, and then I realized I forgot to set my makeup. So then I went back in with the Skindinavia makeup setting spray, which works wonders. I did 4 sprays of this, and then I started in with my dry shampoo. So I had slept with my hair like this the night before up in a bun, and it got really greasy and kind of gross, so I put a whole bunch of dry shampoo in it, and then I teased up the crown of my hair, and then I worked my way around my entire head doing some curls on my 1-inch curling iron, and I just did them all away from my face pretty much like I always do. And I never leave the curling iron in for very long, just a few seconds, enough to basically smooth out the cuticle of the hair so that it's not as frizzy. Then once I did all the curls, I brushed it out and had these nice, beautiful brushed curls. And I put on my handmade fairy crown. I will link in the description for the DIY video on how to make one of these for yourself. And I put on my moss green rags from Tickle Thy Fantasy. And that is my completed look for the first weekend of Ren Faire. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more Get Ready With Me videos, let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, I hope that you subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell next to it, and if you enjoyed this video, please click the like button. It really helps me out.